The biggest grade killer for many students is passivity in their learning. It's as if they expect knowledge to just be naturally absorbed from textbooks and lectures. I've even seen students studying in the library with their frontal lobes right up against their textbook, hoping to capture all those knowledge rays. Thankfully, learning doesn't happen this way. All learning is the result of mental actions that you take with your brain. These are under your conscious control, which means you can direct your learning. Let me show you how this works. When you first read or hear a concept or idea, it goes into short-term memory or working memory. You don't want it there. You want to move that information into long-term memory where it's going to be useful to you on an exam or in real life. The idea cannot go directly into long-term memory. That's the theory of osmotic learning. It has to go through short-term memory first. And there are only two major brain actions that you can take to move information from short-term memory into long-term memory. The first is rehearsal or repetition. If you've ever remembered a phone number by saying it to yourself over and over again as you walked from the telephone book to the phone, and it seemed to just stick in memory, actually it didn't. You used the brain action of repetition to drill it into your long-term memory. The other brain action is elaboration, and it's a much more powerful and useful strategy. Elaboration is more than just repeating information, it's modifying it, connecting it, manipulating it, or changing it in some fashion. Let me give you some examples of ways that you may be using this elaboration strategy already with your learning. One of the more popular ones is for students to engage in a subvocal dialogue with their textbook. They're kind of asking it questions, they're thinking about the material, and they're talking to themselves about what it is that you're reading. This is an elaboration strategy, and it's a very powerful one. Some students will convert the textbook into their own words or connect it to their own personal experiences. This is also a very powerful strategy. Another one is to use diagrams or visuals to summarize large sections of the text. One very powerful elaboration strategy is to treat your textbook as if it were answers to questions and write those questions down in the margin. This is called the question method, and it is covered in more detail in one of the other videos. Ideally, you'd want to use both elaboration and rehearsal strategies in your studying. You might focus on elaboration as you're first learning the material, and then switch to rehearsal to test yourself with that information prior to an exam. Now I'd like to draw your attention to some important features of this theory of learning. First, both rehearsal and elaboration are mental actions, and certain note-taking systems encourage these actions, and other note-taking systems discourage these actions. Whatever note-taking system you decide to use, make sure that your brain is fully engaged in the learning. Second, there is a time limit. Short-term memory is very short. Most studies peg it at under 30 seconds. What this means for students is that you cannot read in a straight line. If you do not stop every paragraph or so and either rehearse or elaborate that material, it will not go into long-term memory. Instead, you must read in small loops. First, read the paragraph, stop, think, assess what's important, and then either elaborate or rehearse that information to make sure that it gets into long-term memory. You may also want to test yourself, see if it's actually made it into long-term memory. There are many different strategies out there that you can use, but when you're looking at a new study strategy, always compare it against this model of learning and make sure that it's either rehearsing or elaborating in a way that's helpful to you.